Good evening, everybody. How are you? It's Jeff Kelman, usaully canine training with my What Would Jeff Do dog training tip of the day, tip number 62. So a lot of people have been asking me lately, if my dog is always heeling next to me on the walk, how do I let it go to the bathroom? It's common question. I was gonna say common sense, but it's not because people are struggling with it. So it's a common question. We like dogs when they're walking next to us to be in a proper heel. We don't do a competition-focused heel. Just walk next to us, no sniffing, no marking, no turning right, no turning left unless we do, no forging ahead, no dilly-dallying behind, no scanning the environment like that. But when it's time for you to go to your dog go to the bathroom, if they stop and like drop trowel and go to the bathroom, you can stop, put them off to the side, maybe not in the middle of the sidewalk, but you also can be walking for like 20 minutes, find a nice little spot, bring them over to the nice little spot. You stop, give the dog the leash, so what is that, 6-foot leash, plant your feet, and then tell your dog to go potty. Don't let your dog pull you to its favorite spot. You determine when its favorite spot is. It'll also help you with your dog going to the bathroom pretty much on command, which helps a lot when you're in a rush or when you're traveling. So a lot of dogs like to sniff, 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 like, and pull you to tree to tree. It doesn't actually need to do that. Like, your dog can learn that, like, right there is the best place in the world to drop trowel and go potty right now. So you can do that, and then you go right back into a heel. If the dog doesn't go to the bathroom in 30 seconds to 45 seconds, it doesn't need to go. Jeff Gelman, solid canine training. What would Jeff do? Dog training tip of the day, tip number 62. Madly in love with you. Talk to you tomorrow.